Hello everyone, now the reason you're watching this is because you want to change the render resolution here. As you can see, I'm free to change it now. You also can see the load here on the memory card. It's not really a big impact, to be honest. But if you still want to change it, we have this option here. So it's now grayed out. If we change the upscale type to none, you're free to change the render resolution to whatever resolution you want. Here it looks like it made a difference, but still it's really, really low. Another thing here, if you put this motion blur too off, it's gonna impact the GPU performance and give you a little boost. Again, same thing for the chromatic aberration. It increases the filmic realistic by emulating the color fringe by a real camera lens. I would go off on this and adjust the depth of field of your game in camera impacts CPU performance. You can also tick this off. Now, if you're interested in changing this resolution here, there are two things that I could do in my case. I could change to the other AOC monitor, which is a 1080p monitor. The resolution is gonna update automatically to that one. Or for this 4K monitor, I could also change from the window settings the display resolution to be 1080p. Again, I noticed it's not gonna have a big impact on the performance here, but it could have a smaller impact here. If I switch to the other monitor, I'm gonna see a big difference when it comes to the load, to the memory load. Now, this is pretty much everything, guys. I hope it was useful here. This is the one that matters, in my opinion. Select the resolution the game is being rendered. Lower resolution will increase the performance, but result in reduced visual quality, obviously. If this was useful, please subscribe and follow those videos as well. I'm sure you're gonna find something interesting. Goodbye.